What Sapporo has to offer to travelers can be summed up in three words: snow, seafood, and smile. Snow, because Sapporo, Japan's northernmost capital, is best enjoyed in the winter months. Seafood, because as Hokkaido's largest city, much of the prefecture's ocean bounty ends up here. And smile, because in a destination as magical as Sapporo, it's something you just can't help doing. Hey there, poor traveler! We are Vince and Yosh, and in this video, we're sharing with you some of the best places to visit and things to do in Spectacular Sapporo. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified when we upload new travel videos. Sapporo Snow Festival. An annual week-long event held in early February, the Sapporo Snow Festival is the biggest winter event in Hokkaido and one of the most popular in Japan. During the festival, the streets are illuminated by lanterns and electric lights, while hundreds of ice sculptures decorate many parts of the city, with the one in OTARU Park getting the most attention. It attracts almost 2 million visitors per year. The festival also hosts a yearly ice sculpting competition with participants from all over the world. Mount Moiwa. Since Hokkaido is also a mountainous region, there are many sightseeing spots that provide different awesome panoramas of the city and the surrounding areas. One of them is Mount Moiwa. The observation deck at the summit presents the most beautiful night view of the Sapporo cityscape. The viewing spot can be reached by taking the ropeway and the mini cable car. Aside from the observation deck, there is also a restaurant where you can have dinner with your special someone or your family while being mesmerized by an ocean of city lights below. To get there, take the streetcar line to Ropeway Iriguchi Station, then take the free shuttle bus or walk to the lower station. Morenuma Park. It spans over 180 hectares in the outskirts of Sapporo and surrounded by the More Marsh. The park has over 100 playground equipment, different types of sports grounds, and thousands of cherry trees. Designed by the famed Japanese-American sculptor Isamu Noguchi, Morenuma Park harbors several works of art, but it is the glass pyramid, Hidamari, that effortlessly stands out. It is situated near the east entrance of the park with three floors where you will find a gallery, a museum shop or souvenir shop, information center, and a restaurant. Another noticeable feature is the 62-meter man-made hill where you can get a good view of the entire park and the surrounding landscapes, even extending to the northern area of Sapporo City. In winter, this becomes a site for sledding and other snow activities.
Ready?
OTARU. OTARU is a separate city, but it's located not too far away that it's often included in most Sapporo itinerary. It is very accessible even if you travel on your own or pull a DIY. This city appears to be straight out of a steampunk anime. When I was there, I felt like I was living my Fullmetal Alchemist dreams. It is best known for its incredibly cinematic canal, which is lined with Western-style buildings. Because of this, one of the most popular activities here is taking a scenic boat cruise down OTARU Canal. Guided tours are available. The tour guide speaks Japanese, but there are multilingual audio guides available for English speakers. The city is also famous for its glass craftsmanship and music box industry. You may simply enter one of the stores and take home one of these pieces as souvenirs. Fushimi Inari Shrine. Not to be confused with the site of the same name in Kyoto, there are countless Inari shrines throughout Japan, all of which were built to honor Inari, the Japanese kami or god of rice, tea, sake, and foxes. Inari shrines are also notable for their rows of vermilion torii gates that mark their entrances. Although the one in Kyoto is the most well-known, it is its relative obscurity that makes the one in Sapporo more special. When we visited, we had the entire place to ourselves. The shrine was established in 1884. Jozankei. Located about an hour away from the city center of Sapporo, Jozankei is the go-to place when it comes to natural hot springs. You can relax and take a dip at any of the spa places located around the area. If you're visiting in winter, check if your trip coincides with Jozankei Yoki Touro, a festival where the Jozankei shrine is surrounded by snow lanterns. It's a really pretty and unforgettable event that you shouldn't miss if your timing is right. Sapporo Beer Museum and Beer Garden. Built in 1987, the Sapporo Beer Museum is the only one of its kind in Japan. It aims to educate visitors on beer culture and the brewing process. There's no entrance fee, but a guided tour costs 500 yen. Afterwards, you may sample the beers or try what locals call the Jenghis can, a dish composed of grilled lamb or mutton and vegetables. It was named after the notorious emperor because in Japan, mutton is a meat often associated with Mongolia. Here's a tip! Make this your last stop of the day. Otherwise, prepare a change of clothes because the smell of smoke will stick with you for the rest of the day. Sapporo TV Tower. Standing almost 150 meters, the TV Tower attracts tourists who are after a 360-degree view of Sapporo City. The observation deck, perched at 90 meters from the ground, also offers a view of the Sea of Japan. Built in 1957 and nestled at the eastern end of Odori Park, the TV Tower is an iconic landmark in Sapporo City. Hokkaido Shrine and Maruyama Park. Maruyama Park encompasses a large portion of the land at the foot of the Maruyama or Maru Mountain in the western part of Sapporo. This park is a designated natural monument. At the northern end of the park is Hokkaido Shrine, the most celebrated Shinto shrine in Sapporo, revering the kami of the soul of Emperor Meiji and the three other Shinto deities. The Sapporo Festival is held here every June. The shrine ground is also a venue for hanami during the cherry blossom period. Okurayama Ski Jump Station. This was the venue of the 90-meter ski jump competition of the Winter Olympics in 1972. There's also an observation deck that gives you a picturesque view of the city. The chairlifts transport passengers to the observation deck. Odori Park. Running from east to west over a kilometer and covering at least 12 blocks, Odori Park is the most well-known park in Sapporo. It serves as a median between the northern and southern portion of the city. In the summer, it is carpeted with verdant trees and grass, but during winter time, any stroll here is made more magical by winter illuminations. You can also get a good view of the long stretch from the Sapporo TV Tower located at the eastern end of the park. Sapporo Clock Tower. The Clock Tower or Tokidai is an iconic building located in the heart of Sapporo City. This western-style wooden structure is the oldest in Sapporo, dating back to the city's establishment in the 1870s, and was originally built to be the Sapporo Agricultural College building. The clock, which still works today, came from Boston and was installed in 1881. Presently, it functions as a museum, telling the history of the structure itself and the city. Kiroro Ice Star Resort. This is a popular skiing destination, but aside from that, the resort also features seasonal ice attractions including an ice bar, a restaurant, and an ice skating rink. Asahiyama Park. Asahiyama Memorial Park was officially launched in 1970 in celebration of Sapporo's 100th anniversary. At 130 meters, the park's highest spot offers a scenic view of the Sea of Japan, Ishikari Heiya, and of course, the Sapporo skyline. Other features of the park include a hanging bridge, a rest house, a Chinese arbor, hiking paths, and food and drink stands. Takino Suzuran Hillside Park. Covering over 390 hectares, Takino Suzuran Hillside Park is another perfect destination for nature lovers and adventure seekers. People of all ages will find something interesting to do and see here all year round across all seasons. The whole park is divided into four zones, but the most recognizable feature is located within the Karyu Zone, the Ashiribetsu Falls, from which the park got its name. Winter activities include tube sledding, skiing, snowboarding, snowshoeing, and cross-country skiing. That's all for now. In our next video, we're gonna dig into Sapporo's food scene and give recommendations on what food treats to try and where to find them. Are you ready for a serving of piping hot miso ramen and delicious soup curry? Subscribe to this channel now so you won't miss it! If you need more information about traveling around Sapporo, you'll find a comprehensive travel guide with a sample itinerary on our blog, www.thepoortraveler.net, or check out the links in the description. If you have questions, make good use of the comment section below. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Just look for @thepoortraveler. You may also follow and tune in to the Poor Traveler podcast on Spotify. See you again next time. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.